Premier Prize.
The first season of the FA Premier League was a season for the fans. They embraced the highs, suffered the lows, and along the way gathered some wonderful memories. New faces emerged, familiar ones battled, others rewrote the history books.
Oh, what a great goal! Oh, what a goal! Andy Shinton! Sheringham goes for goal!
It was a year in which we saw Arkansas Governor Bill Clinton a rank outsider running for presidency. Britain's Olympians made their jubilant return from Barcelona with 20 medals.
Britain's bleary-eyed Olympic team arrives back in London after the celebrations in Barcelona. Among them, the record-breaking rowers Stephen Redgrave and Matthew Pinsent.
But the biggest news for football fans was the launch of Sky Sports Premier League coverage. And just what could we expect?
Goals, excitement, expectation right now, anticipation.
I think there's a lot going to be the same, to be fair, but the main thing is that the difference is going to be is we're covering it, I think, and we're going to give the viewing public something that they've never had before, a more comprehensive coverage of the very best that English football can give them. Every little detail will be explored. There'll be nothing left. No questions will be left at the end of a game, wondering what went wrong with that. I wonder what happened in that decision. I wonder what went wrong there. We'll see everything, and we'll give them the most comprehensive guide they've ever had.
Sky was ready to change the face of football, and it was to be a whole new ball game. Started well for Leeds, the league champions and Charity Shield winners.
Chapman lines it up. Leeds are back in the lead.
While at Bramall Lane, they must have thought Christmas had come early when Brian Deane scored twice to beat the would-be champions. And there was growing anticipation ahead of the first Super Sunday.
Sky Sports proudly presents FA Premier League football. A whole new ball game. Ford Super Sunday. Exclusively live from the City Ground. Nottingham Forest versus Liverpool. Sunday.
Here we go. Weekends will never be the same again. We're here for the next 5 hours with Super Sunday. The centrepiece, Nottingham Forest against Liverpool. The match kicks off at 4 o'clock. Let's meet the rest of the team. David Livingstone will have words with in a moment or so, but it's Martin Tyler there. Martin, good afternoon to you.
Hello, Richard. Yes, we're back at the City Ground. The weather is lovely and the pitch almost seems a shame to go out and play on it.
David Livingstone.
Looking down there, I mean, it's absolutely luxuriant, just like Richard Keys' front lawn, I believe, but it really looks fantastic and we can look forward to the best of football on that surface.
But our preparations have gone reasonably well. And I think you've got yourself a cracking game.
Commentary team, Andy Gray and Martin Tyler. Let's have a word with Andy.
I've made it, Richard. Yes, I'm up here now beside Martin. I actually think there'll be goals. I don't think we'll get a 0-0. I quite fancy Forrest. They're notoriously bad at upsetting Liverpool. I'm going to go 2-1 to Forrest.
Yes, lots of goals, lots of entertainment, and we don't care who wins as long as it's a smashing game, and I hope you're all sitting in your armchairs watching.
Sitting on the fence again, Tyler.
Villa have missed their last two penalties, which is why the job has gone to Gary Parker. On it for Ander. Houghton, who beats the ground with frustration as Parker pops the air in delight, and Aston Villa are in front by 2-1 in an amazing set of circumstances here. Staunton. Houghton is onside, and it's 3-1. Aston Villa finishing here on a very big high indeed.
Well, Ron, very well done. But just exactly how did you manage to transform Aston Villa's performance after half-time?
We decided the proper Aston Villa team would have to come out and play the second half, as we'd be out of the race. Oh, credit to the team, that's what they did. They came out, they rolled the sleeves up, they chased harder, they worked harder, they forced the issue, and, you know, we dominated a fair part of the second half and made things happen.
Since February, Ipswich had plummeted from 4th to 17th in the table, and at last took a much-needed victory over Norwich.
He's going to go alone. And he's put him in as well!
Two days later, a result that proved to be decisive. A Rovers return as Blackburn bashed Villa. The first FA Premier League trophy in sight, and the fans just couldn't wait. Alex Ferguson now on the brink of emulating United legend Sir Matt Busby.
Well, it's safe for us more than time, and we just now have to keep our head and no complacency, and hopefully we can win at Old Trafford.
May saw the final farewell for Brian Clough, and it wasn't to be a fairy tale ending.
Cloughy is known affectionately as Old Big Mouth, but today he had little to say.
Mr. Clough, may we have a quick word with you?
No, sir. Thank you for asking.
I think that's what's known as a polite but firm refusal. For the fans, Clough's departure is the end of an era. Many believe Clough is Nottingham Forest.
What the man has done for this club doesn't bear thinking about, actually. It's very sad.
And, yeah, it's going to be a sad day for all the club. I'm Brian Clough.
Happy retirement, Brian. Good luck to you.
He's done a lot for Nottingham.
Full of emotion here because this week Brian Clough did announce that this will be his last season here, which means that this is his last home match in charge. A club where he's ruled the roost since January 1975, during which time he transformed Nottingham Forest from a run-of-the-mill second division side to become the champions of Europe. But the retirement announcement has come with Forest on the brink of losing their place in the Premier League. The stark reality of 21st place in the table is something that all today's sentiment cannot disguise. Good early ball for Hodges. And still Hodges, it's opened up for him, and that is a top-class finish. Time now for players to stand up and be counted in the colours of Nottingham Forest. And Keane! Oh! The odds very much against a fairy tale finale for Forest, the manager who has meant so much to them. Hartfield. Oh, Gale, a free header! And a goal for Sheffield United! That might be the final nail in the Forest coffin. Brian Clough's final home fixture as manager of Nottingham Forest ends with the club that he has controlled and indeed cherished for more than 18 years being relegated a desperately sad chapter at the end of a compelling story. But Nottingham Forest, the club Brian Clough built in such a remarkable way, this is a bitter, dispiriting afternoon.
I'm happy. Get on, man.
How do you reconcile that with the fact that Nottingham Forest are relegated? And for all the success you've had, you finished on a note which...
That particular side is, I am unhappy, obviously. I would have liked to have won the league championship and certainly won today.
Why do you think Forest have gone down?
We're not good enough.
Simple as that?
Simple as that.
What a Super Sunday we've got in prospect as the last few words are penned in this fascinating tale of two cities. Villa have to win. Manchester holds its breath. When Villa step out today and make this long walk down the tunnel for their last home game of the season, as the club motto says, they'd better be prepared. Point and long here. Staunton and Haller together. Drops for Beckford, who's got a bit of a chance here. And Nick Henry puts it in for Oldham Athletic. Another twist in the plot at the top and bottom of the Premier League. And Nicky Henry has put Oldham ahead here and stunned Villa Park. And it's Saunders who's going to hit it. Oh, he's hit the angle of post and bar. Still bouncing around in there. Was there a hand in there? Appeals for a penalty. Villa were unlucky there. Some of them are close to tears there now. It's sad to see, really, because I've said it before, and Andy said it as well, and we'll repeat it again. Aston Villa have been superb value for money this season. They've already started the party in Manchester. The referee takes another look at his watch. Manchester United are the champions of the Premier League because of this result at Villa Park. The celebrations can start in Manchester. It's congratulations to Alex Ferguson and his team. Alex Ferguson, who said he'd be on the golf course not worrying about Aston Villa. Well, somebody's going to tap him on the shoulder at any moment and tell him, congratulations, Alex. Manchester United are the champions after a 26-year wait. And Villa's season ends in disappointment.
Ron, do you think the nerves and the occasion finally got to the players today? Is that why he didn't really perform?
No, not really. I think, if anything, and I've had this feeling all week, maybe the fact that we got beat at Blackburn. I don't think enough of our boys believed that the championship was still up for grabs. I really don't. I mean, I sensed something in training. I even toyed with the idea of possibly putting two or three of the young kids in and say, go on, give it a fizz. But I decided to go with the boys that have done it all season. And by and large, have done well for us all season. And it was a disappointment. Disappointment, all right. Full marks to Man United. Congratulations, you know. Well done. I thought we might have taken them to the wire. I think the competition's been that good this year, we should have taken them to the wire. We should have made them play for the championship on the field. I mean, I think we've handed it to them on a plate.
It's going to be the biggest celebration in these parts for a quarter of a century. The party started when Villa's challenge died. A lot of people have been here at Old Trafford ever since. Some slept here, most have been here since midday. United are champions again, and they're going to tell the world about it. This is the prize for United, the glittering new trophy that will be on display here at Old Trafford for the next 12 months. We'll see it presented to the champions at the end of the match tonight.
They said it couldn't be done, but it was bigger and better than ever before. After 26 years, the wait was finally over. Manchester United have won the first FA Premier League title. So Matt Busby at Old Trafford to relive history. Celebrations had to be put on hold for a little while longer. Another 90 minutes wasn't going to make much difference, was it?
Gallagher going in! And Kevin Gallagher has steered in a splendid goal here. But it's Giggs who takes it to that side! And Mims, wherever it came from, didn't have it covered. It's a goal worthy of the occasion.
Maybe just
now Manchester United are enjoying the difference. Instead of playing for the championship, they're playing as champions. It's... There you are. The credentials are there again.
I know it's Gary Pallas that's round the ball. He hasn't scored this season, has he? I just wonder if they're saying, go on, big man, have a go.
The crown is there to be received. Yes, he has that! Oh! The crown and glory! Manchester United are the champions of England for the eighth time. And the very first under the auspices of the FA Premier League. The ultimate...
It's a wonderful, wonderful night. You strive all your life to get a feeling like tonight and experience an atmosphere like we have tonight. I've never seen anything like my life.
One of the great nights, really. We get very emotional here at the club. You know, Europe and the big matches are... A few of us have been lucky enough to see them before, and you wonder if they'll ever come back again, but tonight was just sensational, really.
The final Saturday of the season saw the end of the road for Palace. Oldham's win against Southampton enough to keep them up.
Manchester United fans have flown in from all over the world to be here today to pay tribute to Alex Ferguson's team. United, England's most internationally renowned club, and at last properly honoured again in their own land. There's no offside here. It's a great chance for Robson. And he's done it! And that's what Manchester United wanted. Manchester United go off despite a week of back-slapping and glass-raising. They maintain their marvellous form right to the very end. A seventh straight win to finish with a real flourish. 24 wins in all in the Premier League, 12 draws, 6 defeats, exactly the same figures as their last title-winning team of 1967.
Sky Sports viewers had indeed witnessed a whole new ball game and a fine start to the Premier League. The 92-93 season ended with Manchester United 10 points clear of Villa at the top. At the bottom, Forest days in the top flight had come to an end, Borough and Crystal Palace going down with them.
We're shouting for the gunners! We're gonna win the cup!
Lenigan! And it's a goal for Arsenal! They've won the cup!
So Arsenal were to go on to become FA Cup winners, but the season belonged to a club already steeped in history. Winning no longer just a memory for the league's very best, they'd done their predecessors proud, and Manchester United were to weave their magic for some time to come.
Hit the premier. And into the net. By Ince. Oh, what a